Hey guys, welcome back. So I did promise you a house tour in my previous video. I think I put it in the comment section or something like that. But yeah, I did promise you a house tour, so I'm gonna go ahead and do that now. And we are standing at the entrance of our apartment, and behind me is the door. So I'm not gonna, well, okay, I'll show you a little bit. That's a creepy looking hallway, isn't it? Anyway, so this is the main entrance. Once you walk forward, so we've got our shoes there and our coat hanger because it's winter. That's why it's filled with scarves and coats. I need to put something in here so that I can put my bag on there because my Coach bag shouldn't be sitting on the floor. Anyway, there is another shoe rack that is in the bedroom. I'll show you that later. But this is the hallway. So straight down there is the living area. We'll get to that in a little bit. And the first left is where you will find the bathroom. So this is our bathroom situation here. Okay, so I was talking about the bathroom before I was interrupted by the builder ringing the bell because there was a little bit of a problem with our bathroom. And so, anyway, here we are in the bathroom. And the problem was that this was smashed open when we had the issue with the toilet. Anyway, I'll talk about that a little bit more. So, but this is the bathroom. I love the shower. Right, although I find that the bath is a little bit too small. So the problem here was when we first arrived, the half flush wasn't working, but the full flush was working. And then 2 nights into moving in, it all stopped working. So we had to call in the plumber. And because of the stupid idea that they had about sealing off the entire cistern, there was actually a marble that's like this on here, and then underneath that was another layer of mosaic tiles. So they had to smash through those 2 layers to get into the cistern, and even after that, it was almost impossible to get in there and actually fix the problem. So what then had to happen was they had to make a makeshift sort of like platform so that the presser, because something fell off, yeah, so that the presser would then reach the actual pump, I guess is what it's called, and then release the water that's in there. So anyway, that's been fixed, and today the builder came to seal it off, but this time around he didn't seal it off in such a way that it would replicate this, but more of that so that if it ever happens again and we have to get into the cistern, they just have to remove the grout and lift this white thing open, and then they can get in. Okay, so anyway, that's too much info there, but yeah, this is what the bathroom looks like. I've got here the toothpaste, some hanging things in there, some everyday essentials, and this is what's inside. I need to figure out a way to properly sort this out, but so far that's been working for us. That's where we keep most of our, because I always keep a stock of stuff that we need. So yeah, that's sorted. And then on the first left, yeah, apart from the bathroom, you've got the master's bedroom here. So this is where me and Duncan sleep. There's a huge ass window over there that overlooks the main street. It's quite noisy in here because this is a main road and like all the buses and cars pass through here. So that's a bummer, but other than that, it's okay. Love the exposed beams and the brick. We've got built-in wall. Okay, so Duncan's side of the wardrobe is over there, and mine is here. Now, that last door there is where we keep our undergarments and our socks and jeans and stuff. The ones that don't get to be hung because those are shelves, the other ones are hanging. I don't really want to talk about Duncan's wardrobe, but here is mine. Okay, so I put an over-the-door hook there so that I can put my belts on there. Here are my bags that are in their dust bags. This container here has got my off-season shoes, like my flats, and my sandals because it's winter, so I'm not gonna be wearing that. And here you've got all of my clothes that I'm wearing this winter. So I've got my bottoms on one side, I've got my t-shirts and my my long sleeve shirts, my turtlenecks. I've got hoodies and coats on this side. There's a few things at the bottom which are like towels and, what do you call this, bed sheets. All right. And then underneath this bed is actually, this is a storage bed. It's a gas lift one. And again, it has a few of the things that I, some things that I don't wear right now because it is winter, so all my summer clothes are in there. Duncan pretty much wears the same things the whole year. He just puts on a leather layer like a coat when it's cold. Here we've got the shoe rack that I was talking about a little earlier, and I used it as the stand for the TV as well. And then on this side, I've got my vanity. So all of that stuff. I've used a cork board to organize my accessories. This is his side where he's got documents in there, and this is my side where I've got my perfumes and makeup bags with a few things that are like backups. Okay, I've got my makeup bag there, the clear one where I have the rest of my collection. It all fits into that one bag. Okay, now moving on, I've got here my laundry area, and as you can hear, I'm actually doing a set of laundry right now. We've got my whites in at the moment. Okay, so that dryer is there. It's built in, it's owned by the owner of the house. And we brought our own washing machine on here. Okay, now enough with the noise. Right. Okay, now moving forward, here we've got in the hallway. So there's another storage area here. It's a closet, and that's where the ducting for the air conditioning is at, but also like where our luggages are, an IKEA bag filled with reusable bags, a huge paper bag that's filled with other paper bags so that whenever we need it, it's right there, and boxes of some appliances that we didn't really want to let go. Okay. There is some noise going on outside. Okay, second bedroom. Okay, so this is a spare bedroom for guests, but sometimes I use this room when Duncan is snoring quite a bit much and I can't sleep. Okay, so this one here, I've got my hobbies at the bottom, so my planning stuff are in there. And then on the second shelf are my nail care and extra things like my masks, where I dry my brushes, restocks or backups of my sponge cleanser, some body butters and other stuff. And then random things on here, mostly my camera stuff and my sewing machine. I was using this clothes rack when we were in the old apartment because we didn't have built-in robes there, but I decided to keep it because like when I do videos on like sort of like fashion-y stuff or things that I've thrifted, then I'm going to be using that. So that's the spare bed. This is the bed that we had originally in the old apartment. We bought the other bed entirely new. This here, this is what you see. Okay, all good at the top and then track bottoms. That's a YouTuber's life. Anyway, so this wardrobe here has been here. It's one from the owner. This one I brought from the old apartment. Okay, that's our own portable air conditioner and fan and whatever. So again, huge windows with blinds. That's the second room. When my mom comes over for a holiday, then she's staying there. And then this is the living area. Okay, this is the kitchen. We've put everything together. Obviously the built-ins, dishwasher, the oven and the stove, and the, what do you call this? Microwave has been there, but everything else we've brought with us. They're all filled with stuff. Like that has got are drinking glasses over there. This one's here. I've got our coffee mugs, plates, and all other crockery. This is more of a pantry, and this is where I keep most of my dry goods. Here we've got our coffee pods and other things. I've actually posted on here what the different coffees are because I can't memorize them. Yeah, because we got the Nespresso Virtual, and it came actually with the frother that's on the drying rack at the moment. So that's what the kitchen looks like. We've got some of our, this is my baking stuff in there, pots and pans in here. And then under here is like the kitchen cleaning stuff and my slow cooker. Utensils and a few other baking stuff. And we didn't have a space to put these on, so we've actually just placed it on there on display for others to see. And yeah, so that's that. And this is the living area. I've actually built this sofa myself from IKEA. This is the Vimle four-seater with chaise. What is that noise? Oh, I don't know what that truck is, but it's noisy. Anyway, I've built that. And I am going to actually insert a short clip here that I did of a time lapse of me building this. I also built the chairs, the bar stools, and the bar table. And I also built that IKEA Kallax shelf over there. But that one, I bought secondhand from a friend. So I didn't even go through like the time lapse for this. Just these ones here and this one here. Now that fridge is there because I did a stupid thing where I actually measured the space in there and it fit perfectly, like perfectly, exact measurements, but I didn't realize that this here had skirting on it, so we couldn't fit it, the bottom in, because of the skirting, and we didn't want to take it off because it's not our house, we're renting. Obviously you know my bike, and I put on some artwork as well. These are pictures from our travels that I took. So this is the Louvre in Paris. This is a stack of hay mills were from Duncan's hometown in Inverness in Scotland. Then we've got here, this is the Science Center in Valencia, Spain. Then these are also photos from our travels together. So this one is in Ha Long Bay in Vietnam. This one is in Sydney when he came to visit me. This one is in Ho Chi Minh in Vietnam on my birthday. This was me at H&M using their furniture, Duncan, when we were in Dalat. our Christmas together in Scotland. This is the Christmas that I came to see him after I moved back to Australia. And this, I believe, is in... Ooh, where is that? I'm not sure if it's in Cambodia or in Laos. But yeah, one of those places. Then we've got a cafe in Paris that I took a picture of and made it black and white but left the heart red. And then this is... I'm a little confused if this was in Paris or in London. Okay, anyway, yeah, so, and I've also got my collection of Starbucks mugs on there and some other knickknacks, Duncan's cookbooks, because if you don't know, he's a chef, and a little wine bar here. I got the wine rack for $20 off of Facebook Marketplace. And then, I'm not a drinker, but those are Duncan's. He bought me the strawberries and cream Baileys. I'm not sure if I'm up for that. He's a fan of red wines, so he takes care of that. Then whenever he finishes a wine, he uses the bottle as a candle holder. So there we go. Okay, sorry, I got interrupted again. This time it's the technician for the internet who's coming over in about 10 minutes. So he's gonna fix the internet because it's been 3 weeks since we had internet and I've been using my mobile data and that is racking up a very high fee. So anyway, that is it for the house tour. Let me know if you have any questions. If you wanted me to link where the furnitures are from, but they're really just from IKEA. Everything is from IKEA apart from the stuff that we brought from the old apartment, which are also from IKEA. Anyways, I hope you enjoyed this little home tour and the time lapse of me building all these things. And if you have any questions or comments, please let me know in the comment section down below. And if you want to give me suggestions on what you want to see in the future, I'm thinking of a thrifting haul because this Saturday there is the Glebe Market. And on Sunday, there is a suitcase rummage that's close to where I live. So I might go there. Even if I don't buy anything, I'll film it so you guys can see what happens here in Sydney in terms of that secondhand market, which I'm very keen on taking advantage of. All right. Anyway, I'll see you all again in the next video. Bye.